All right, not all right. This one is right. Good. Giz and F. All right, let's get the... Yeah. Let's get this out. So this is... You have to be careful. Don't crush the charge pipe here. Then, pallet. This is a plastic pallet on a carton. I don't know if you can understand what I'm saying. It's a plastic pallet. What happened today? Today, we brought this pallet from the office. On this pallet, there was the transmission and the transfer case. All right. I put the dual mass flywheel, torque it down properly on specs. The same thing with the transmission, the same thing with the transfer case, the heat shield, what you see here and here. Then the transmission heat exchanger, the pipes, the coolant pipe. I'm not sure about the breather, honestly, for the transmission. I don't know if I wrote properly, maybe. It's supposed to be like that, it's supposed to come somewhere there, but we can find out. Okay. Starter back in place. This here, where it's supposed to be, 1 second, turn on the light. This bolt has been torqued down, this has been torqued down. The other one inside of the starter has been torqued down. Then there is another one there inside, and there is another one short down there because there is no space to put it. And so the coolant line back in place properly, the position sensor is over there. Okay, this we saw that earlier. AC lines, I didn't put it. First we're gonna put the engine in, and then we're gonna put the AC lines. The bracket there for the heat exchanger. What I was going to say, there is one bolt here that's not been torqued down. This I'll gonna torque it down when we put it on the car, and there is another one in the middle that's missing. Ah, you see what it is? I put by mistake here.
Yeah.
All right. This is supposed to be the same with that one, with this one down here. Yeah, you know what?
That's a mistake what I did. That's a mistake.
This bolt, if you see here on the transfer case, you see that I put here with Allen? This with Allen bolt, it's supposed to be bolted down. And this one that has, it's a flat, it's supposed to be bolted here. So I have to swap these bolts. Right? Right, because if I adjust from the rest what they have, it's the same. Yep, no worries. Here, where is the bracket for the transmission? I found only two, I don't have another one here inside. All right. Then I put, let me remove also this. This is supposed to come here. This is where it's passing the coolant lines for the expansion tank that comes somewhere here up, all right? So this is supposed to be here, either here up or here down. This one, whoops, come back. Leave it back again in the box here inside. So, pretty much that's it. Pay attention. There is a rag under the chain to don't make any scratch on the coils or anywhere. And like I said, what I did, I opened this. All right, to don't bend this bracket like it bent right now and hit this one and break. So this at the end when we finish, I'm gonna make it again straight to be able to put the actuator. Otherwise, you're not gonna have a chance to put the actuator. Another thing, when comes the time now to grab the engine, we're gonna grab it at three points. One point you're gonna be here, another one point you're gonna be here, and then we're gonna fix another one here to split the weight. So don't grab all the engine only from two brackets. Because if you see, this bracket has one pin and one bolt. And the other one has, I think, two bolts. Yeah, the other one has two bolts here, but it's thin. So, I'm gonna make another one bracket here. That's it pretty much. That's the status. I want to see also if it's bothering this bracket. Maybe not, maybe yes, we're gonna see. If it's bothering, I have to open this, the heat seal, remove the bolt from here and then insert it later. That's a different story. That's it. So the fuel lines and the charcoal canister line, it's been blocked. The inlet's been blocked. The charge pipe,
All right, beautiful coolant lines. Yeah, the coolant lines not so much because we're gonna cover now all the engine until it comes the time to put it on. That's it. One small update. Now, whenever we have available jack, then they're gonna say from the office to bring the car. Over there it's the SLK, over there it's the Porsche, here's the C63, behind the GLE. Go figure out. That's it pretty much. Thank you very much. We're gonna see updates from this engine when we're gonna put it inside and we're gonna start it, probably. Except if the owner, he told us that he does want to wait and he'll gonna get the engine. That's a different story. So, let me show you also what other parts I have. I have these bolts and then, just let's go to the box. And then we have, like I said, the coolant expansion tank with some lines here, AC lines that need to be washed. This is how I received it, by the way. I didn't throw it here inside. The two axles. This is supposed to be for the colder intake, and this is supposed to be the charge pipe from the intercooler to the throttle. From the intercooler to the throttle, yes, goes front. And this need to be washed because it has sand inside. It's not the best. This is the middle mount. This bracket is supposed to go to the engine mount, if I remember correct. We're gonna see about that. And one plastic bracket for the battery, where it goes to the air filter, the battery, something like that. So that's it, pretty much. Like I said, next time you're gonna see the first start, or you're not gonna see anything because if the customer he decide to get the engine, you're gonna fix somewhere else. We're gonna see about that. Thank you. Now, the engine will gonna stay here, outside of the engine room. By the way, it's blocked, eh? It's not been open. What I wanna say, for a couple of bolts that I'm a little bit confused now, when I'm gonna receive also the car and the brackets and all these things, then all the bolts will gonna make sense. So for now, like I said, some bolts I have to remove from there, I have to put down. It's gonna happen, there is no problem, not a big deal. Again, if I was the one that opened the engine, then I'm gonna remember exactly what's going and where it's going. But it's not the case. Anyhow, we're gonna figure it out. Worst case scenario, we have the workshop manual, right? We're gonna open the computer, we're gonna see where it's going each bolt, to don't make any mistake. And I said late earlier that this bolt goes here, most of all it's not going here, most of all it goes like this here on the mount and it's coming the lines. I'm gonna figure it out. No problem, no worries. For now, covering it, nylon bag from the bottom till up. Some bolts are here, the box with some other new parts are here, and the other box over there with the axles. All together in one position, in one spot. Don't looking for the parts later on. Now that's the end. Thank you very much.